Now is the time, Portal Master.
Hey everyone, this is Mike with SkylanderNuts.com. I'm coming to you today with another Swap Force character review for Knockout Terrafin. Knockout Terrafin is a Series 3 Skylanders that shows up in Swap Force. This means he has another character in Skylanders Giants, which is known as Terrafin Series 2, and he has the original Terrafin, which came with Spyro's Adventure. So he can be played in any of those three games. Knockout Terrafin is a core Skylander. This means he does not swap with the other swappable characters of Swap Force. You can buy him separately right now for about $9.99, or you can pick him up in the Fiery Forge Battle Pack. The Battle Pack gives you an extra arena to battle in, and it comes with Bumble Blast. So you get a couple things with Knockout Terrafin if you go that route. Alright, let's put him on the portal and take a closer look at Knockout Terrafin.
There he is, Series 3, Knockout Terrafin. Now, if you're a longtime fan of Skylanders, then you know he's an Earth Skylander. But I did forget to mention that before, so if you're new, know that Terrafin is an Earth Skylander. In fact, he's a land shark, and land sharks like to burrow underground. This will become one of his major attacks when we look at his attacks in a few minutes. For now, though, look at those big brass gauntlets. Look at these things on his fists. They even have Wolverine-like spikes. They're huge. Based on that, you know he's going to deliver some melee punching power. Look at that. They're huge. That's pretty much all that's exciting about Terrafin. He's otherwise just a shark. Doesn't have a lot of flare or flash to him. Kind of average. It's kind of the way he's always been. I mean, you know what you're getting if you already played with Terrafin. If not, then let's go jump into the game and show you what Terrafin's attacks can do, especially since they're all maxed out and upgraded.
It's feeding time!
Super hungry.
Hey, it's Mike, and I'm here with Connor to talk about Terrafin. Knockout Terrafin. This is the Series 3 Terrafin. He's pretty much got the same moves as the old Series 2 Terrafin, and he's got one extra wow pow that's different over the Series 1 Terrafin. How you doing, Connor?
Good.
Alright, you ready to use Terrafin?
Yeah, hurry up.
Alright, here we go. We're doing the first arena battle again. So the first attack Connor's going to show you is the basic punch. It's Terrafin's most powerful and most used attack. Simply just press the X button and Terrafin does some damage.
I'm waiting until a lot of enemies are following me. So I can defeat them.
All right, we'll try a combo. That's X, X, and hold X.
X, X.
Boom. There you go. That was pretty nice.
X, X. Oh. Boom!
Yeah.
It's good against these Squeevils. Boom.
It's good against a large number of characters. Bad guys on the screen. Alright, so some of Terrafin's upgrades are brass knuckles. You can see he's got the gold Wolverine-like blades on his hands. That's an upgrade that allows his punches to do more damage. We also chose the Brawler path, where he has the spiked knuckles upgrade. That's where his punch attacks do even more damage. So there's two upgrades just for punch attacks. Show him some different combos. Do an XXY or an XXB. There's the body slam. That's an upgrade for the brawler path. XXB button.
But I almost got him.
That's okay. You're showing people moves. That's all right. You didn't need the help anyway.
Hey, it's in stage one and it's really stage two.
Do it XXY.
Oh, XXY. So XXY.
Nope. XXY.
XXY.
There it is. A little bit of uppercut.
XX. Oops.
Oh, that's okay. You just showed him Feeding Frenzy. That's an upgrade where if you hit the Y button, you'll send out a little
sharks. Go ahead and do that a few times, even though... Nope, that's not it. That's the B button.
Oh, it's Y button.
Yep. That is called Earth Swim. That's where you go ahead and burrow underground. That's an old-time favorite of Terrafin there. The Y button sends out the sharks. There you go. They go in a straight line, though, so you gotta shoot them at the enemy.
Like this.
Well.
I missed.
Those, yeah. It's a better attack when there's lots of guys straight in front of you. These guys are a little different.
Can I just punch these guys?
Yeah, you can just punch those guys.
It's very easy. If I punch these guys, it's very useful.
Yep, and I think that's the problem with Terrafin. He is a one attack character, really. All you have to do is punch. He is very powerful. Punching does a lot of damage. It's quick. And there's really no need to focus on any of the combos.
Even though if he heals him. Hey, Daddy, I defeated a guy even though he healed 100 health to him.
Well, that's because Terrafin is very strong.
Yes! Now it's time for the light spell.
Yep, Terrafin is very strong and he can overrun the light spell on spells sometimes.
I'll just get
Oh, now you got two life spell punks out there, though.
There's one.
All right, well, show him the belly flop. Do the earth swim again. Press the B button to go underground. And now press the X button to come out of ground.
Boom!
That does some damage.
I'll punch this guy, and then...
That does damage to a large range of enemies.
Boom!
There you got him. Now, that attack isn't too bad. We use that a lot when there's a lot of...
Boom!
You want to go underneath. Go underneath his... Ooh, you missed. You can go...
Wow.
There it is. Now, we also have the Mega Belly Flop upgrade. That allows his Belly Flop attack there to do increased damage.
I'm doing the sharks at him. Wait. Bam!
Now, we have an upgrade you probably couldn't tell called Multi-Target Punches. Sometimes his... punches there will attack multiple enemies, which I don't know if that if it doesn't ever do that. That's a weird upgrade.
Final stage. Oh, I'm gonna leave all this for the stage.
All right. Now he has a soul gem ability called Surface Feeder that allows him to collect those power ups when underground. Of course, he didn't show you that. But that could have been a good idea.
So when I'm underground. So I can get experience points.
Yeah, you can get the experience when you're underground, I guess. It allows you to pick up, go pick up that pizza, maybe. There you go. It's nice. It's not a great soul gem ability, but it could be helpful. Use the Y button. Show him the...
Shark!
Oh, you know what? Here, you gotta show him something else. You gotta show him the Wow Pow. You gotta go underground, and then press the Y button. Jump up. There he goes. He does his little dive. Little mini sharks come out at the same time. And you just,
punch.
Don't just punch him, honey. Use the attack.
There's the sharks. I'll just go in the back.
Use the Wow Pow.
So, what button again?
Alright, again, you go underground, you press the Y button to jump out. It only helps, though, if you are aimed at the bad guys. If you're running away from bad guys, it doesn't do you any good.
I need to use my
go underground. Just go underground and circle around. There you go. Jump out of ground with the Y button. Over and over again. While you're underground. Okay, once again, for the Wow Pow, go underground and hit the Y button. Come out of ground. Every time you hit the Y button, there you go. He's flashing at people. And as he flashes at people, all those little mini sharks come out as well. There you go. That's how you aim it at people. You do a lot of damage and then those mini sharks will take care of the rest.
Can I punch the easy toppings? Ooh, I need to punch that guy.
Yeah, go get the life spell on. That's okay. Now, we also have something called Frenzy Shield, which is part of the Brawler Path upgrade. That launches mini sharks every time you get hit. So, there you go, you leveled up. Go get that life spell punk. So that's kind of a hard one to realize too. As Connor gets hit sometimes.
Only heals the
Let that guy punch you once. Let that guy punch you. No, let him punch you. Okay, well, we won't see that one, I guess. But that does it for Knockout Terrafin. That's about all of his attacks that we could go through. There is one other path that we did not choose called the Sandhog Path. That sounds pretty cool. That increases his burrowing speed. There's an upgrade to be able to damage people while you're underground with his dorsal fin. That seems like that might be helpful. And Homing Frenzy, where the mini sharks hone in on enemies to do extra damage. As you saw Connor try to use the mini sharks earlier, those sharks did not. They went in a straight line. So if you missed the bad guys, you missed them. But it sounds like this upgrade would allow those sharks to turn and attack an enemy directly. That would have been helpful.
So if the enemy's not chasing, if the enemy moves, the shark will just follow the enemy?
That's what it sounds like that upgrade would have done. So we chose the Brawler Path, which gave Connor those combos, the XXY and the XXB button that did the body slam and the uppercut. As you could tell, they're not easy to pull off, and they don't really help you any. It's more of a pain to try to do that than it is just to punch people over and over again.
I only got 2 stars.
No, that's okay. So I would not suggest the Brawler Path. I would go with the Sandhog Path, even though that's not the one we chose. Alright, so I think that does it for Knockout Terrafin. Visit our website at SkylanderNuts.com for the written review and a score on Knockout Terrafin. He was a great character in the first game, but I think he's kind of a one-trick pony right now. He's just a brawler. If you like the brawling and punching, he's pretty powerful. But other than that, we didn't really think he had too many exciting attacks. We definitely like throwing the little sharks at people, but, you know, they don't do a whole lot of damage. The belly flop's not bad. It helps you get out of a dangerous situation, but for the most part, punching is the way to go with Terrafin. You got anything you want to add? Mm. You like Terrafin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? You like using them? We use them sometimes. But I think in this day and age, there are more interesting Skylanders to use now. So, all right, that wraps it up. We'll see you next time at SkylanderNuts.com for another character review.